using ggplot, how to use colors. Fine. So that is the primary agenda in how to bring in colors into our visualizations. So first and foremost, let us make a basic chart and we'll try to use colors into it. Okay. As I told you, whenever we are making a visualization, first thing is to run this command option scipy-n. Okay. What is the purpose of this? What is the purpose of option scipy-n command? See, now you are flipping. It will remove all the scientific values that comes onto your visualization. Like you may get values like 1e plus 0.6, these kind of notations. So it will remove those things. Okay. So first let us run this option scipy-n. So that will be taken care of. Next is, whenever we are running the session for the first time, we put the package in our library. Okay. Yesterday I did not do that and some people started getting errors just because of that. So today I write that command also, library ggplot. Okay. Now, all of you are ready? Now just see, you have imported your data using CSV. I'll be importing the data from the URL. Okay. So it is very simple. I'm just giving the name for the data Midwest. The name is already there for you, Midwest. Is equal to the basic command read.csv. Okay, so basic, you know, read.csv, and then you write file.choose and all. But right now I'm not choosing a file, I'm taking it from URL. You have your file. Okay, so just see, I have pasted the URL like this, read.csv, and in bracket double quotes I paste the URL and I run the command. My data is ready. Okay, R has pulled out the data from that URL. Okay, you want to see that, then I can just do the head thing, head Midwest, then you can see this is the data. Okay, whatever data you have, I have pulled out the same data. Now it is there with me. So every time you don't need to, you know, import it through a CSV or Excel file. The data can be on the website. You can pull it out from there. Okay, it saves a lot of hard disk and saves a lot of, you know, your disk space. All those things. So let the data be there on the URL. You can bring it from there itself. Okay. Now just see, all of you, whatever you are doing, just hold. Okay. Up till now, nothing new was there. Just hold, stop over here. I want all of you to focus on what I am about to say. Listen carefully. Okay. Now, can you see this? Let us try to observe the variables that I have. One variable is PID, some ID. Okay. And then I have country, I have state, I have area, population, all these things. Okay. I want you to tell me, listen carefully. I want you to tell me which is a numeric data and which is a categorical data. Agree? I want you to tell me what is a numeric data and what is a categorical data. Okay. Categorical means nominal or something. Okay. Now just see, what is PID? It is just an ID. ID is numeric or non-numeric? It is always non-numeric. We consider IDs non-numeric. Your registration number, your roll number, your Aadhaar card number, your PAN card number, your telephone number, they are non-numeric. They are just nominal data. That is only used for identification. Can I find the average roll number of the class? Can I find the average phone number of this class? And even if I do that, is there a purpose for that? Getting the point? So, even if it looks like a number, the purpose is for identification, recognition. Okay. So it doesn't serve any numeric purpose. Okay. Number two, look carefully. Don't look into your laptops. Look here. Okay. Because this is one very important aspect. If you miss out on this, you will be in problem. Okay. Then you have country. Okay. Country is numeric or non-numeric? Non-numeric. Okay. State. Non-numeric. After that, all these area, population, these are numeric. And then you have category. Category is non-numeric. Okay. Now listen. Okay. I have various variables in my data set. Listen very carefully. I have various variables in my data set. Some are numeric, some are non-numeric. Okay. You can never use a numeric variable for adding color. I will repeat, you can never use a numeric variable for adding color. Is that clear? आप इतना दुखी क्यों हो रहे हो? Okay. I'll repeat again. समझ में नहीं आ रहा तो समझा रहा हूं. Numeric data जो भी है, okay? Like for example, area. I cannot use area for adding color. Okay? I cannot use pop total to add color. I cannot use pop density to add color. If you remember yesterday, we used the iris file. In the iris file, which column did we use to add color? Species. Species was numeric or non-numeric? Non-numeric. We got Virginica, Sentosa, Versicolor, something. They were non-numeric. Okay. So what we understand is a numeric column can never be used for adding color. Is that clear? So what are we left out with? What are we left out with? Non-numeric. So we can use a non-numeric column for adding color. ठीक है? We can use a non-numeric column to add color. Okay? And now, this is important. Listen carefully. The non-numeric column, for example, let us say, here it is country. Okay? Now, if I just check class, I'm writing, you don't have to do anything. You just listen, understand. If you have any doubts, you ask. Class. Okay? I say Midwest. Whosever phone it is, please put it on silent or switch it off. Midwest, dollar, let us say country. I just want to check the class of this variable. Okay. What does it say? Okay. It says it is a factor. Okay. Let us check the another thing. Class, Midwest. Dollar, what was other? State. Okay. It is a factor. Okay. What do you mean by factor? What is a factor? Factor is a non-numeric categorical data which can be used for categories. Are you understanding? Like I have around 25 students sitting in front of me. If I know the states of you people, state A, state B, state C. Okay. So can I classify you people based on your states? Can I create categories? I can. For each category, I can assign a color. Getting the point? People from Punjab, one color. People from UP, one color. People from Bihar, one color. People from South, one color. So I can assign colors based on categories. Okay. So understand, non-numeric, check the class, it has to be factor. If it is not a factor, convert that into a factor. Right now I checked, luckily it is a factor. Or else let us say you get it as a character. Okay. Then you will say as dot factor and put that variable, it will get converted into a factor. Is that making sense? So I'll make things very simple. In your data, you will find two types of variables. One is numeric, one is non-numeric. Forget about numeric. We will not use numeric for adding color. Okay. I am mentioning this categorically. You can never use a numeric data for adding color. Is this part clear? Isko hatate hain. You have non-numeric data. Okay. When you have non-numeric data, what will I do? I will check its class. If it is a factor, I can straight away use it. If it is not a factor, I will convert it into a factor. And how will I convert it into a factor? As dot factor. Okay. Write as dot factor and put that variable. Is that part clear? So it will get converted into a factor. If you have understood this, I will go to the next part and tell you another interesting and important point. Did you understand this part? So are you clear which kind of variable can be used for adding color? First, it has to be non-numeric. Number two, it has to be a factor. ठीक है छोड़ अभी फोकस करते हैं ओके तो फर्स्ट थिंग इट कैन नॉट बी अ न्यूमेरिक डेटा नंबर वन ठीक है इट हैज टू बी नॉन न्यूमेरिक नंबर टू नंबर थ्री इट हैज टू बी अ फैक्टर इज दिस पार्ट क्लियर नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू टेल सम वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट लिसन दिस केयरफुली इट कैन बी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड बट लिसन टू इट केयरफुली ओके देयर कुड बी केसेस ओके देयर कुड बी केसेस व्हेन यू मे हैव अ न्यूमेरिक डेटा which can be used as factor. In some cases, you will have a numeric data which can be used as a factor. Are you understanding? Is this point sinking into your mind? There can be numeric data which can be used as a factor. Are you understanding this? Okay. Now, when I say numeric data can be used as a factor, what do I mean by that? Now just see, we have our favorite data set, empty cars, right? Okay. Now just see, in empty cars, can you find this variable cylinder? Can you find gear? Okay. Now just see, cylinder. There are some sixes, there are some fours, there are some fives or eights. Means there are some six cylinder vehicles, some eight cylinder vehicles, some four cylinder vehicles. That is to say, can I use this as categories? I can use this numeric variable also to classify the cars into categories. Like these are the cars which are four cylinder cars. These are the cars which are six cylinder cars. These are the cars which are eight cylinder cars. Getting the point? In that case, you can use that numeric variable also to add color. But again, it has to be a factor. देखो ये कैटेगरी है लेकिन हमें क्या चाहिए कलर देने के लिए फैक्टर ही होना है इवन इफ इट इज अ कैटेगोरिकल इफ इट इज नॉट अ फैक्टर व्हाट डिड आई टेल आई हैव टू कन्वर्ट इट इनटू अ फैक्टर ओके सो एंड थिंग इवन इफ इट इज न्यूमेरिक फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड दिस न्यूमेरिक कैन आई यूज इट एज अ कैटेगरी I understand, okay, there can be four cylinder car category, there can be six cylinder car category, there can be eight cylinder car category. Clear. Even if this is possible, if it is not a factor, I cannot use it. It has to be a factor to use it to bring in color. Okay, now let us check. So next, what should I do? Check for class. Class, empty cars, dollar. Cylinder, okay. Okay, what is the outcome? Just see, it is numeric now. Samajh mein hai? Now, can I use it as a category? Can I use it for coloring? How? I cannot use. Numeric cannot be used. That's what I have been telling from the beginning. But I want to use now because I know. With my common sense, I know I can use it for categorizing. My mind is telling me that I can have a four-cylinder category, I can have a six-cylinder category, I can have an eight-cylinder category. But the problem is it is numeric. I have to change it into factor. This is the point I am trying to drive in. Okay, how will I change? As dot factor. Okay, bracket again. Empty cars, dollar. And cylinder. Okay. Now before running it, I will just give it a name. Let us say I give it a name C. Yeah, CI kar deta hun, CY. Okay. I'm just giving it a name because I want to check the class of something. No? After changing, I need to check the class of something. So I want to create a new variable called CY where I am changing cylinder into factor. Okay. So when I run, I want to check the class of CY now. Okay. Now what is the outcome I am getting? factor.
Do you understand? So now cylinder is converted into CY
and CY has become a factor. Now I can use CY to add color. You see, we are just at the beginning of learning ggplots. Okay. And if you don't understand these things right now, when we move on to complex graphs, and when I just write, you know, nested commands, like I'm writing a command within the command, I write as dot factor equals something, some variable, you will not understand why I did this. So that is the reason I'm spending so much of time to just explain one small little thing. Are you getting it? Ye dekho, ye pura, matlab, ek second ka kaam hai. Lekin I'm spending one entire lecture to make you understand what is happening. Because later on, when we do complex graphing, at that point of a time, I will just write this part somewhere and you will not understand why did I write. Is that making sense? Okay. So please appreciate what has happened. Okay. So the learning that we acquired till now, what is that? First thing, how to add colors. We are trying to learn which variable to use to add colors. Number one. Okay. Number two, eliminate numeric. I will use only categorical. Okay. Those categorical, when I am saying categorical means it can be numeric or non-numeric, but it can be category. Okay. Like just now we saw a numeric data can be used as category. Okay. And if it is a character or if it is a numeric, I will have to change it into factor. Character hai, tab bhi factor mein change karo. Numeric hai, tab bhi factor mein change karo. Is that making sense? Okay. Straight away character cannot be used. Straight away numeric cannot be used. Is this clear? Any doubts, please ask. Kuch hai doubt? Kuch dimag mein chal raha hai? Okay. So I hope you are in a position to understand what variables can be used for adding color. Okay. So right now in my Midwest data set, I can use country, maybe I can use state. Okay. And there was some other column. Okay. So there are three variables which probably could be used for coloring. Okay. Okay. And one more, if I want to add more information and if you are capable enough to absorb that, a column like we have cylinder or gear, which I used for factor. Okay. One another hint could be, it will always be a discrete value. It will never be in a continuous value. It will never be in decimals or anything. It will always be a discrete value. Non-decimal kind of. Okay. Like cylinder. I cannot have 4.5 cylinders. I cannot have 3.5 gears. Getting the point? So that is what is discrete values. Fine. So let us move ahead with coloring part. Okay. So my data is imported. I have checked my data. I did my eyeballing, like I checked it head. Okay. Now moving ahead. First, the layer. First layer for ggplot. All of us know, right? Ggplot data, comma mapping. Data is Midwest. Okay. And how do I do the mapping? Aesthetics, whatever on x-axis, whatever on y-axis. Okay. So with this, my coordinates or my grid would be ready. Okay. Now you can see my grid is ready. Fine. And I hope this should be very comfortable for you because we have been doing this for past two or three lectures. Okay. Then next I will make a simple scatter plot. So I'll add another line of command, that is another layer, that is geom point. Okay. So again, for this, there should be no doubts. Okay. Now I did my geom points. So I have some points. Okay. Now let us see. I will do this smoothening, that line also. Okay. We have learned that geom point. I'll add another thing. Geom smooth. Okay. Okay. This is the new line I am adding. That is geom smooth. Okay. Geom smooth method LM. Okay. These are always already done. Okay. Don't get excited for this because this is nothing new. Let us come to the new part. So this smoothening is done. So you will get this line also. Okay. You can see the line also is created. Okay. Now, coming to the main thing that we are doing today, that is coloring. Okay. Now let us see. First geom point. Okay. As I told you yesterday, we did yesterday's agenda was entirely coloring only, aesthetics. Okay. So now, where do we add aesthetics for color? With geom point or whichever graph we want, right? So geom point. Now straight away, I wrote color equals to steel blue size 3. This was done yesterday. Okay. So that's nothing new. Okay. And now the new thing that we are doing now is geom smooth. There also method LM. There also you can write color. Okay. This steel blue, fire brick, all these will come only if you have that R color brewer installed. We have installed a package in the beginning. Remember R color brewer. So if you have that package, only then you will get these colors, steel blue, all these fancy colors. Okay. So we have just added those colors. This is basic coloring. I haven't used any factors. Okay. Now you can see I have some steel blue. Okay. Up till now, whatever we did, we have discussed earlier as well. Okay. There is nothing new. Okay. Now moving. Now see, we will be using some variable from our own data set to add colors. Okay. Now, as I told you, we can use country, we can use state, and the last column, there was some column. Okay. Only three columns could be used for color. So now just see. Okay. Now I've created one ggplot. Okay. When I come to geom point, see here, geom point, I use aesthetics. We learned it yesterday. Aesthetics, within aesthetics, color equals to, I'm using state. Color equals to state. Okay. I'm using the variable state. Okay. And size equals to, I'm just writing 3 or any number as I told you yesterday. Okay. So create that. I will plot my GG. Okay. Now you can see I have a plot where I have many colors. Okay. This looks colorful, right? So state wise, there is IL, IN, MI, CH, WI. Okay. Maybe this IL should be Illinois, IN. What is IN state in US? IN, I don't know. MI should be Michigan, CH should be Chicago, and WI should be Washington, maybe. Okay. So these various colors represent various states. Okay. Okay. Now in your color brewer package, okay, there are many sets of colors. Okay. You can choose any set of your choice. Just simply, okay, I have created GG. Okay, I have created my chart is entirely saved in an object called GG. Okay. Now after that, you can change the entire look and feel by adding one more layer. Okay. That is scale color brewer. Okay. Now I am adding one more layer to GG. GG ke baad ek plus lagaya. Plus is used for adding layers. Okay. So the new command I am giving you, up till now everything was common. New command that I am adding today is scale underscore color underscore brewer. Scale color brewer. Okay. So I'm just adding one layer to my GG. Scale color brewer. Okay. Within the brackets, you will just write palette equals to. Okay. P-A-L-E-T-T-E. Palette. Palette equals to. Use There are many sets. You write set 1, set 2, set 3, whatever in double quotes. Okay. In set S is caps. Okay. And when you run that, an entirely new palette, entirely new color combinations according to the set would be created. Okay. Now you can see a new color combination has come. So you keep changing the sets, you will start getting new colors. Okay. Like right now I have set 1. If I make it set 2, okay, you should get new colors. Already pre-installed color combinations are there. Okay. Now just see, when I say set 2, entirely new color combination comes. Just I have one line, just one line. Okay. And then I will finish off with. Okay. So this is how you can keep changing all the color combinations. But primary learning, okay, fundamental learning that you should acquire is which variable to use for adding color. Okay. Rest of the things are mechanical. Rest of the things your R will decide. Okay. It can do. But what is the intellectual thing you are contributing to this? Which variable, not color, color the pre-installed, which variable to choose for coloring? That is a human decision you have to make. The rest of the things are pre-installed. Only the human decision that you are making is which variable to use for adding color. If you understand that, the rest of the things are very simple, because most of the errors that we commit is because of choosing wrong variable. The variable has to be categorical. The variable has to be a factor. Got the point? So if you are fulfilling these two conditions, that variable can be used for coloring. Okay. So in the next lecture, what we learned is coloring. In the next lecture, we will learn the scaling part. You can see all the dots are lying at the bottom somewhere. I want it to be properly distributed across my chart. That means my scales are not good in this existing chart. So I can align my scales also properly. So in the next lecture, the primary objective would be how to scale the chart. Is this clear? Okay. Now,
Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle.